Hi everybody, this is Ellen. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to make the Happy Pretzel. I think it turned out rather fabulous. This one I made using gold jelly bands. You could use caramel or, although this one was a different one I made that I didn't like totally, I used like pink lemonade or something. So then the tutorial I'm going to use some purple to make a pretty one. But lots of different color choices, doesn't have to be right on. You could add little salt to it, but I chose not to. I think it's just pretty this way. So, band-wise, it is a little heavy. It's 490 bands for the entire thing. Then you'll have your eyes, either 7mm pony beads or a wrapped band, then your cheeks and a mouth. So, I love how it turned out. I hope you do too. I'll put this over here. We'll get started with making the eyes and the cheeks first. I use the 7mm pony beads, and then this piece of craft wire that I folded in half, or you could use string thread or floss or something and get into a V shape. Then you take two bands, put them down in the center, close it up, and thread it through your bead. Use bigger beads and you don't need the threading thing, but then you pull it out and you have a beaded eye band. If you do not have the beads, you can use a wrapped band for the eye, just one band, whatever color you want the eye to be, on the hook, wrap it around into a figure eight, grab both bands, wrap them around again, and then pull through two bands the color of your pretzel. And pull it down to the center, and you have a wrapped band eye band, so you'd have either two of these or two of these. And then you have the cheeks, which are made the same way as the eyes, it's just whatever color you want the cheeks to be, on the hook, wrap it around to the figure eight. Both bands, wrap them around again, and then pull through two bands the color of your pretzel, or the color of your cheeks, the color of your pretzel. Yeah, I had it right the first time. So you have two cheeks. So you want those made ahead of time, and then we're on one loom, wrong end towards me, and we're going to kind of start in the middle section here. I'll probably start the fifth pin up, in the staggered position. We actually need to make this a little bit easier, we're going to make a little piece that goes right here, and then we're going to put that on the loom, and then we're just going to kind of ignore it as we go along. So, get your bands. Everything is double banded, so it's always two bands. So I'll start here, and we're going to make three X's up the loom. So, kind of up and to the right, and then two bands will go right across the top of that to make an X. And then we just do that two more times. Like that. Then we'll need cap bands on each of these two pins up here. It's two bands wrapped around one time. Like that. Then we're going to take our hook and we'll go through. You want to make sure you start on the side where the bands are underneath, just in case you put your X's on a different way, but the band that's underneath, you're going to go into that cap band, grab those bands, pull them up, and then pull them all the way back across the loom to the other side. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. Through the cap band, pull it up, bring it back over. And then again, make sure that the band that you're starting with for this next X is on the bottom. Go in and pull it up, pull it back across. And then come back and do the other side. And last time. So now we're going to ignore this for quite a while. On the next part, we actually kind of start, technically we're going to start down here, and then we kind of work our way around and down and back out. So the next part is the kind of some repetitive pattern around the outside. But we're going to, instead of putting it right on top, which is where it'll have to be later, we're going to work them kind of out a little ways so we don't have to worry about catching these bands the entire time. So what we're going to do is the one side of the pretzel is going to be worked here, and the other side will be worked up here. And we're going to do a 4-pin starburst, I guess. So from this pin right here, I'm just going to go out to the 4 pins on the side. These are still double banded. Just like that. We'll put a cap band on here. 2 bands wrapped around 3 times. So 1, 2, and 3. So that one here, and then we'll do the exact same thing up here. So the four bands out, and then the cap band wrapped around 3 times. And that. So whatever I do on this one, it's pretty much the exact same on the one up here. Just we do a little bit of kind of opposite a couple times, but we'll go in through the cap band, grab the top 2 bands wherever they are, they go to the outside, pull them up, and pull them back towards themselves, and do that all the way around the 4 pins. Like that. And then repeat up here. That. So now on each one of our little X's here, we're going to do a row around, and for those of you who want to kind of jump ahead, we do 6 rows in total. So it's 2 bands, and we go all the way around each little square or rectangle, however you want to look at it, I guess. All the way around. And whatever I do down here, I repeat up here at the same time, that way I don't lose my place of where I am. All the way around up here. Like that. Then you go and you'll flip the bottom, excuse me, the bottom 4 bands all the way around. Do the same thing up here. Push those down. So that's 1 row. I'll mark it over here. Then we need to do 5 more rows just like that. So 2 bands all the way around. So there's a little bit of repetitiveness to this, like I said, but it's all worth it. Same thing up here. Like that. Flip the bottom 4 again. Same thing. Oops. Push it down. So that's the second row. And if you want, right now you can go in this middle pin, grab your cap band, it's pretty easy, and just pull it up over the top of the pin, because it is a growing up design. We just don't want to get stuck down there too far. Same thing down here. So we'll do our 3rd row, 2 bands all the way around each side. Same thing up here. This is the part doing the sides that kind of take the longest, and then once you go through the middle, you're like, it goes pretty quick. So again, flip the bottom four. Glitter, dual layer glitter bands. I can't remember if they're, I think they're just maybe purple or something, but I didn't realize before I started using them the other day that they actually, the glitter actually comes off. Like you can see it on my desk here. So I have glitter all over. So that was our third row. Another row. Your fourth row. Two bands all the way around. For Easter, got my daughter this crazy, or not crazy, but it was a very beautiful dress to wear. Definitely dressed her up more than I probably needed to, but I could do that. But it had little glitter dots on it that looked like they were all very attached, but like that, flip the bottom four again. But there was apparently like extra glitter in the tulle of the skirt. So she's just glittering everywhere. And of course my husband had worn a black shirt. So he's just covered in glitter. And it's like, it's all over. She wanted him most of the day. Little daddy's girl, I guess. And he had glitter on his face. And I felt kind of bad for him because... And then, of course, his brother, as we're all together for Easter, he's giving him a hard time about it. So that's our fourth row. Fifth row. They're so cute. And, of course, you wash the dress, and then there's glitter on all the clothes. And yeah, I probably shouldn't have washed it with other things, but... When you get six people in a house and you have to do laundry, sometimes things go together that shouldn't. So then you flip the bottom four again. So that's the fifth row, and you can see I'm still just kind of pulling up the center, so it keeps coming up. And then our sixth row all the way around. I'm gonna move these now. We got it. I've been keeping track pretty good. So we got my youngest son. He got a nice little Easter suit, and he was just... so adorable in it, and nice little tie and vest, and he's so cute. He said he was styling. That, flip the bottom four. Alright. So that's our six rows. Keep pulling it up. And if you need to count to make sure, just kind of start at a pin. And that little cross piece, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So you just kind of make sure you have all your six rows. So what we're going to do is kind of the turning up here. So how we're going to do that is we start by doing, I call them half rows, although they're a little bit more than half. We're going to do bands that are the left, middle, and then right on the lower side. And then over here, it'll be left, the middle, towards the middle of the loom, and then down here. So we kind of, as it grows, we put the bands in the center. These pieces will start to grow out this way. Oof. I got a frog in my throat. So, two bands still. And then the cross one goes in the center area. So like that. And then on this end, it's the opposite. as I think of it as the opposite, but the sides and the part towards the center. Like that. So just have your crossband towards the center part here. And then when we flip, we're only going to flip the bands that are on the pins on the inside of the little piece we put on. So we'll flip the four bands here, four bands over here, and that's all we'll flip on each one. So on the other side, there'll be the four towards the center, and this four. You know if it kind of goofs up, because if you flip over, don't actually do this now, if you flip these over, it just kind of, it doesn't look right. You'll see that it's not connected the way it should, so. But we just want the center ones. So we're going to do the exact same thing right on top of that. So two bands around the center. And up here, right on top of the last one. And then once again, only flip the four pins that are towards the inside. And flip the bottom four. And push all those down. And now we're going to do a row all the way around each piece. Still two bands. So this time all the way around. Same thing up here. Like that. And this time when we flip, we're going to flip all four pins on each one. So the one towards the inside, it'll be the four bands to flip. But then the outside ones, you're going to have the four from the two rows we just did for the half rows. So those are going to go over. And then the four from way before to go over as well. And the same thing on each side. And this will come up. Then you do the same thing on the other end. Four on the center, towards the center ones. And the outside ones will have the eight. And again, you can pull that up. So what we just did, the two half rows and the full row, I call that a set. So if you want to go ahead, you're going to want to do four more sets, because it's five in total. So again, we'll do a half row around, and this will be our second set. So half row on each side. Flip only the middle four pins. Down. Do another half row right on top of the last one. And the other side. Another half row. So then again, flip on the middle four. Them down. I know it's tempting to pull up the middle when we have the half rows on. It won't actually really come up very well, so just wait till you get the full row around, which is next here. So all the way around this time. Same thing on the other end. All the way around. So go ahead and flip like before. Be 8 bands on the outside pins. And 4 bands on the center pins. So down here, the center pins, 4. And the outside will have the 8. Push those down. Pull up your center. And it should start to come, like this one that I have now, should start to kind of lean towards me as I pull it up. And this one up here will start leaning away. As it comes up. So that was our second. 3 more to go. So again, the half rows. On each side. Flip the middle ones, or the center ones. Push down, another half row. And again, you'll flip the center. Then we'll have a row all the way around. Like that. Do it on both ends. And again, the same thing. Be 8 bands on the outside ones and 4 bands on the center. And down here. Push them down and pull up the middle. So that was our third one. And if you get kind of lost, you can check too. It creates a bigger bump. And you could just go all the way back up and count your rows, because we had 6, and then we'll have the big bumps here, which will be there'll be 5 of them, but they kind of creates bigger bumps in the sun and underneath the curve. So if you get lost, you can check too. But we have the fourth set to do. So again, the half rows. Thank you. Well, like I said, this the first part's kind of long and repetitive, but flip the center ones. But once we get this part done, then it goes pretty quickly. I hope. Do you feel that way too? Another half row, right on top of the last. And same up here. And then flip the centers. Push them down. Then we do a row all the way around. Both sides. And then flip like before. Eight on the outside. Four in the center. Both ends. Then again, pull up the center. Always be careful because you don't want to pull anything off the pins. Our fourth row, and then we have one more set to go, or fourth set, so now we have one more set to go. So again, the half rows, all these curly bands. Like that, flip the centers. Down. Another half row right on top. Both sides. Flip the centers. Down, and a row all the way around. Round on the other side. And flip them like before. Okay. push them down, pull up your centers. Alright, so now's where we have to start moving some things around. This lower one we are going to move up. We're going to start working over the top of our little three X's here. You still want to just ignore these bands completely. It gets a little tough as we get a little further along because we put up some bands on top of them and then you know, you have to kind of separate them out, but just know that we don't use these for a little while yet, but it just has made it easier to make this before we move on. But this one right here, or these four bands, we're going to move them up so they're sitting right here. So it's a little ways up. So the stretch, you probably won't be able to stretch them all the way up to where we need them to be the first time. So I'm just going to pick up the top, or pick up the bands on one side, and I'll stretch them up to kind of this middle pin right here. Do that on both sides. And grab these, and we'll stretch them up to right below. And just be careful as you're moving them. Make sure you get all the bands back onto the next pin. Move these up. So we have it up to here, but we do need to move it up to one more pin up. So I'm going to grab these bands again and move them up one. Same thing over on this side. Move them up. Just kind of position over the top of that pin just like it was before we moved it. So you can see where that one is now. It's kind of on the center, it's on the center two pins of that underneath part that we're ignoring, but I'm pointing out right now, of course. So you have that one there. Push those down, and then the one up here is going to move so that these two, the bands that are on these two pins, are going to overlap in the center here. I'll pick these up. And I'll bring them down right on top of where the other ones are. I'll do the same thing over here. And these will move up to the pin below. Center this. That's how it should look right now. So we have the doubled bands here from above, and then they're spread out, and then we still have the extra part over here from underneath that we're not doing anything on top of yet. So now we want to do a row around these six pins right here, just on the portion that we just put the tops on. So two bands right on top. And it's a little, like I said, squishy because we have, like on this one, we have almost 12 bands, I think, so. Do the best you can to get them all around. Squish down. It gets a little easier once we get this row flipped, so. So like that, we have the bands all the way around these six pins. So when we flip up here on the corner, we ignore the bottom four bands that are part of those that three X's we put on, and we want to flip the middle four bands. The top four bands are the row we just put on. So you'll get in there, find those middle four bands, and flip those over the top. In the middle here, we want to flip the middle eight bands. So again, you're going to ignore the bottom four bands. And sometimes it helps if you can kind of come around a side and just get parts of it. But we want to flip the middle eight, leaving the top four and the bottom four. And you just want to go and make sure to count to see if you got them all or not. I have an extra one I can see. so there's only 4 on the bottom and 4 on the top left. And the same thing over here, we do on the end, we flip the middle 4. See why I tried to avoid doing this on the top before? Would have been a little tricky. And we do the same thing on the other side. This side, for whatever reason, is always easier for me, but the middle 4 up here on the top pin. Right here is the middle 8. And then the middle 4. Like that. And you should be able to see that there's a divide between what's working on the top and the part we're ignoring on the bottom. There shouldn't be any connecting bands between there. If you did, then you flipped over part of the bottom bands. You want to fix that. So now we're going to do the eye row. See, we're working so fast now, we're getting there. So the eyes are going to go on the front here. We're still working on the 6 pins, so 2 bands. I'm going to start down here. And then the eyes go on the next 2 spots. And then it'll be 2 bands in the next 3 spots around. Like that. So now all the way around, you'll flip the middle 4 bands, leaving the top and the bottom alone. You probably have to pause because, I mean, I've made this one a few times and done this many times, so I can kind of pick out the middle 4 easier, but I know when I first started doing it, it took me a while to be like, is that the right middle 4? And again, keep checking in that center area to make sure that there is space in between, that nothing's flipped over from the bottom. And push down on your 6 pins there. Next row is our cheek row. So it's the same as the eye row, it's just we're going to put cheeks in the front now. So I'm going to start with 2 bands down here, and then a cheek. And then another cheek. And then 2 bands in the next 3 spots around. So again, flip the middle 4. Like so. Now we'll put the mouth band on. to the mouth, whatever color you want it to be, on the hook, wrapped around into the figure eight. And then the bands, the top four bands on the pin in the center of the two cheeks, you'll take those, pull them up on your hook, slide your mouth band down. Try not to have them fall off your hook, that would be bad. Slide the mouth band down, and then the bands that are on your hook will go right back onto the pin. Like that. Now we're going to do another row all the way around. Our six pins, anyways. Like that. The bands are kind of twisty right there. Okay. And again, flip the middle four. Like that. Looking good. So now what we need to do is we're at this point right underneath the face here. So we split now to do the parts that come down so we have the little center hole. And how we're going to do that is on this part towards you where we have these two extra the bands on the pins down here we haven't been using. We're going to take the top four bands on the next two pins up and bring them down to the outside. So top four, bring them down. Top four, bring them down. And then in the center here, or the center of our top portion here that we're still kind of looking at, on the back side, hopefully, you should be able to pick up the top two bands that are there. And they should be able to come right down to this next pin. The top two bands that are on my hook are connected to this pin down below. So I'm just going to bring those down. So it gives us a nice divide right here in the center. On the front, however, I need to pick up all four bands because if I just picked up the top two, the bands that I have on my hook are connected to this hook or to this pin above where my finger is. We don't want that because it'll be a crossover in the front of the face. So what we do is we'll pick up all four bands, bring them down a pin, and now we can pick up those top two bands and bring them back up, and there's no crossing in the center. Yep. Oh, you think you're sneaky. Almost lost one. Got to be careful. So now it should look like this. We have there's four bands on these two corner pins on the top. In the center here, there's two bands, and then there's still the four bands that are underneath on that lower part. And it's the same way on the back side. So you kind of want to center the top if you can. Be careful, like I pulled off one of those bands when I was doing that, but saved it. So now what we want to do is we're going to treat each, there's eight pins here, front and back. We're going to treat four pins as being one half and four pins being the other half. So what we need to do to be able to do that, so we're going to take two bands. You could either use your rainbow loom hook, a long crochet hook, or like I destroyed one of my latch hooks and took out the hooky part or the latch part. But you need to be able to take your hook, come down through the center, between the top portion up here where we have all this created and then that bottom part we're ignoring. Take your hook, push it through to the back side or to a side. Take two bands and you're going to pull them underneath. I usually take the two bands that are on my finger over here. I'll latch them right on top of the pin as I pull through. So I'm pulling through. I'll put one end on the pin over here. Keep pulling these out underneath and then on top on the other side. So you can kind of see underneath here. You have all the X's, but then here's my underneath bands that I just pulled through right here. They just go straight across. Look through this way. Make sure that you didn't stick your hook through any of the stuff on the bottom. It's pretty tight, so it would be hard to unless you really were kind of pushing or forcing. But you want to make sure that the bands we just pulled through just go straight under in between the top portion and the bottom portion. So we want to do that again on this other middle pin right here. And like I said, you can't use the rainbow loom hook. It just takes a little bit more time. And since people usually tell me my tutorials are too long, I'm going to use the longer hook. So again, I just pulled two bands underneath everything and they're on top of here. If you've made like my gingerbread man or my reindeer or any of the things with legs, it's the same stuff. So now once we've got the two bands pulled up to the center, then I'm going to do one end is going to be from this, I call it the center pin, but the upper center pin around on these four pins, and then we'll go around on the four pins below. So two bands up here, around, and here. And then on the other end, it'll be two bands around the lower end. So we technically have the band that goes underneath right here, and then we go around this side. And the same thing over here. There's a band that goes underneath, and it comes around for here. So like I said, we're just dividing for this portion right here of the pretzel. So then when we flip, the corners are going to be four bands that we flip over. And then right here in the center, it's going to be the bottom two bands this first time around. Make sure you get the bottom two from when we moved these around from the big portion and not the two bands that we pulled up through the middle. But it's just two bands, and then we leave four there. And it gets a little tricky because I found that the bands we pull up through the center, sometimes they kind of overlap or seem lower than they really are in the lineup, I guess. But then this pin, again, is four. So we leave four behind. And over here it's the same thing. Four in the corner, two in the center. Two here. And four. And then to kind of help along as we start, because we have to do this two more times all the way around like we just did, I usually tuck these end pieces in so it helps to kind of push up the center. After this next row, it gets much easier, but once again, pull through the two bands onto these center pins like before. Hook through, Grab your bands, pull them through, and you just put them on the pins. Do the other side. And like I said, always check in the center to make sure you didn't go through anything on the bottom. And then your bands around the outsides of each half of the pretzel divide. Like that. So now when we flip, it'll be the middle four bands on all pins. Like I said, I usually in here in the center part, that band we pull through, it kind of can look deceiving as to where it lays, so take your time a little bit more on the center pins. Flipped off an extra one. There we go. Again, check your center. You can unhook the bands. Pop them up and pull them towards the center. And I should have much more room underneath for the next row and last row that goes underneath like that. So again, underneath. Last time. Pull through those middle bands first. To very nice. Now that I have all this room to go under, making it all difficult. Alright, middle bands are on. Now go around the outside. All the way around. Like that. And then again, flip the middle four. all of them flipped. Like so. So now we have the divide for the pretzel legs. So now what we want to do is we're going to stretch this out again. Then we're going to basically move our bands out one pin on the top here. So on this top portion, just go in, grab the top four bands, move them up one. Same thing over here. And then the next one's down, move those up one. Like that. And you want to unhook them if they get stuck on the pins underneath. Just be careful about it. Make sure that end is pushed down. And we'll do the same thing on the other end. You just want to take the top four bands and move them down a pin. Make sure to get them all back onto the pin before you take your hook out. And again, check to make sure you're unstuck from the pin. So it should look like this now. So now what we're going to do is we need to attach these ends to what we're working on. So I'm just going to kind of hold these straight, and if I flip up the end, take a look here. It's not going to be a huge deal if you pick up the wrong set of bands, or if you use some from the kind of the second row or the first row. It's not a huge deal either way, but just kind of so you're consistent with, as this comes around, there's an outside and there's an inside. We first want to work with the inside. So we flip this up, and you'll see you can either use these bands that are right here, which are technically the first row that we flipped over, or you can use the bands that are kind of inside, that are a little bit turned. Either way, whatever bands you want, just use the lower, the half that as you hold this up is on the inside. And I'm just going to take my hook. I think I'll use the inside ones this time. Take my hook through the four bands that are there, and this will be the one that's on the right side for me. So on my hook, I'm going to go and grab these four bands that are on this pin, pull them up, pull them through, and then put them back onto the pin. So it looks like that. So then it's usually pretty easy. I can see that I pulled them through here, so the next set of bands is right here for me. I'll find these four bands, put my hook through them, and I'll go over here, grab those four bands that are on the pin, pull them off, pull them through, and then back onto the pin. So now it is attached nicely. We do the same thing on the other side. Again, make sure that you're working with the inside of the curve here. Just kind of flip it up. So I have it on my hook. come down, grab those bands, pull them through, and then back onto the pin. And just kind of turn it to the side, and I'll be able to see here's my next ones because they're right across from what I was just working on. Put my hook through there, grab the next ones, take them, pull them through, and then put it back onto the pin. So now we have kind of a weirdly shaped B, I guess. So once you have that done, you can push your bands down all around. And then we're going to add a row all the way around this entire thing. So two bands. And up here where we've put these pieces on, the bands kind of want to pop right up there to the top. So just get your bands on there. Push them down. But we're going all the way around, right across the center and everything. We are finally going to start to use those ignored bands that I pointed out several times. Maybe ignore bands isn't the right term for them, but those bands in the center. Like that, all the way around. So now when we flip on the ends, it'll be the bottom four. These bands have kind of like two colors to them, obviously. They're like dual layer, but it makes it hard to make sure I'm flipping the right one sometimes. And then on the second pin, it'll be the eight below the top four. So you have the middle ones from when we expanded, and then we're finally going to take up and pull over those ignore bands over the top. That'll be the bottom four in the middle, bottom four, that'll be eight. So all the way around on every pin, we're going to be left with four bands. Corners eight. Same thing on the other side. Like that. So four bands left on every pin around. Push your bands down. So now we're going to, again, add our bands here on the end. So you want to find whatever bands you were using. So I have right here. So my next ones are right here. So I'll take my, I was going to say fork, take my hook and stick it through there. And then once again, I'm just going to grab those four bands that are left on the pin and pull them up through that center. And then put them back onto the pin. And I'll do the same thing with the last one that's left. So right here. All four of those bands on my hook. Then grab the corner, pull them up through, and then back onto the pin. So now that should be totally connected now on that end. Do the same thing over on the other end. Find where you were working. So these four. Grab them, pull them up through, back on the pin. So now this other end should be completely connected as well. So we are getting there, almost done. Push your bands down. So now what we want to do is, before we go on, we're going to reduce this top left corner and this bottom right corner. So how we're going to do that, so you go in and you'll grab the top two bands, lift them up, and those are the top two. You want to make sure you have the two bands that kind of go together. It's like when I pick that up, you can tell that like these two were together when I put them on the loom. And these ones are coming from the left side here. So I'm going to take them over to the right. So you just want to take them to the opposite side. So then these bands right here, they're coming from the right side, so they'll come over to the left. Like that. And then this lower corner down here, same thing. Just grab the top two bands, figure out where they're coming from. Mine are coming from the right, so they're going to come over to the left. Put them right on that pin. Then the other bands are going to go to the opposite side. Like that. Push those down. Then we're going to do a row all the way around. Two bands. We are almost done. I think I might have said that a little earlier when I probably was kind of, I think I was just excited to get done with the repetitive part, because then once we get into this other part, it's kind of like it goes super, feels like it goes much faster than the repetitive part, although I'm sure it probably still takes a while. I haven't been watching my time. It's probably like 5 hours. So we have that row all the way around. So on the corner pins, you're going to have the reducing band, or two bands. So the two reducing bands are going to go over, and then the bottom four will go over as well. And then the middle ones will have four bands. And again, the end here is going to have those two reducing bands, and then the lower four. Same thing here, two reducing bands, lower four, and these middle ones will just have four. And we have a reducing band, and the lower four. I think I grabbed the wrong four. Wrong two. I always like to grab that reducing band first, because then I can see better where the other ones are. I saw you. There we go. Back on your pen. There. Like so. Push everything down. Now we're going to reduce one more time these far corners, the upper right and the lower left. Same thing as before. Just grab the top two bands. See where they're coming from. Mine are coming from the left here. So they're going to go over to the right. And the other ones are going to come to the left. And then up here, top two bands are coming from the left, so they're going to go to the right. And then the other ones will go to the left. So we're going to do another row all the way around with the two bands.
I just realized I could pretend all my glitter is salt.
So much glitter. So like that, go all the way around. The corners are all going to have those reducing bands again. Middles will just have the four to flip. Same thing. Reducing band. And four. There we go. Reducing band. All right. So now what you're going to do, we are going to close next, but you'll probably want to take your hook and unstick the center area. Just kind of pull it up. Be careful you don't pull anything off the pins. It should look like that. So you want to push everything down. And we are going to close this by kind of braiding the bottom. What do I mean by that? Is I'm going to kind of push this down towards the loom. I'm going to take my hook. I'm going to go in through the four bands, starting on the right, or you can start on the left, doesn't matter, but four bands over here, take them off. Then I'll go over to the left. Those bands can come off or they can kind of stay on the pin, however you can work it. But then the four bands from the left are going to go through the four bands from the right. Like that. And then we'll come back to the right. Those four bands will come through. And we'll go to the left. And just keep alternating as you go. If you keep your pretzel smooshed towards the loom, the band shouldn't pop off. Just take your time. And if you kind of notice when I pull these off, I grab them and I turn my hook a little bit and then pull it down and through. That way there's more room for the bands to come through, or the hook to come through the bands. As you get to the last ones, you want to make sure that nothing pops off, so I'm going to cover this one over on the left with my thumb. Grab the right ones, pull them through, and then come over to the left, get them both on my hook, so like that. And I'll take my two bands, pull them through, all the eight bands that were on my hook, both ends on, make a slip knot. I use the jelly bands, so they don't always stick quite as well together, but, and then I'm going to hide my tail. I'll have to come up through this section right here, because these aren't really connected to, because there's that starburst there in the way. Come up through, grab my tail, pull it inside. And I snag something else, of course, not sure where. But you want to pull until it hides that end. Like that. You may have to adjust right here. I noticed it with the other pretzels I made too, just because of how they were pulled. But you just kind of adjust it around the side. Put your hook in there and pull them through. The little kind of puffier ones are from that first row in the, or it's actually the starburst portion for this one right here, that are, they're not quite as tight as like the later rows. So if you need to, you can just pull those back in a little bit and make them tighter. Just take your hook, pull them in. Not a huge deal. I usually just kind of blend down the sides here. And believe me, I wish it turned out, you take out the loom and everything's all fancy and sparkly and you don't have to make any adjustments, but it doesn't always work out that way because they are rubber bands. So, like so. But you can do that and make your, just kind of fix your seam here where we connected the two pieces together. And then you have an awesome pretzel. Might do a little stretching your center or the sides or anything like that to make it fixed a little bit. Fix your cheeks. Pull out your mouth. So he has a nice smile. Not like that. He's messing with me. The cross in the mouth band is in the front, so sometimes that makes the smile look weird. So I gotta fix it. That's better. So, super sweet, awesome, adorable pretzel for you. I hope that you like it. I think it's totally cute. I love how, of course, I love how sturdy all the things are that I make. I feel like it's something that you'll actually want to hang on to and keep, and it won't fall off anywhere. Not something that you'll be like, oh, I'm going to take that apart and make something else because you just love the way it turned out. Well, this was an earlier one that didn't quite work out. I still think it's pretty. So, but I hope that you enjoyed making these with me. I know it took a while. I can tell now I look at the time, and it definitely took a little while. But I definitely appreciate you guys watching these. I'm working as fast as I can. A lot of things have been going on lately. It's crazy. A lot of family stuff. So doing the best I can. Sorry, I'm not quite as many as I was before. But I have to balance my health and family and things a little bit better. So, but thank you guys very much for watching. I definitely appreciate it. If you make some of these, of course, I would love for you to share them with me on my Instagram, which is at Crafting Fantastic, or on my Facebook page, which is feelinspiffy or Crafting Fantastic. And then, of course, it would be fantastic if you subscribe to my channel. I'm really excited. I can't believe where I am. I'm still, like, in awe. It's crazy. And then, of course, we do the big thumbs up if you like the video and you like my pretzel. So, but thank you guys very much, and I will have more for you soon.